Next up, I'm not going to play this whole thing, but it's a great video. It's from Jack Chappell, and it just goes up as far as history goes. And what it really just lays out in 18 minutes, I'll just paraphrase everything in 20 seconds, is revolutions. And the first one, 1700s, was the agricultural revolution, and that was China, India, and they pretty much controlled the big lion's share of that. Then, in the 1800s, we had the first industrial revolution. This is by Great Britain. They invented machine-powered factories, worked more than thousands of people, steam engines, metal factories, military, etc., right? And just remember this, whoever adopts the first technology wins for the next 50 to 100 years. Then in the 1900s, the U.S. took over, the second industrial revolution. We had electricity, railroads, petroleum, combustion engine. Again, whoever adopts first usually wins for 50 to 100 years. Then in the 2000s, the third industrial revolution came about, again by the U.S., and some may say Japan and maybe even Russia, but computers, electronics, nuclear power. And again, whoever adopts first wins. Now we're getting to, and things are kind of speeding up, now we're in the 2020s, going to 2030s, the fourth revolution is here. And that, from what this video talks about, and I truly agree, is artificial intelligence and the financial system, to paraphrase. So when we talk about who really wants to be the first one here, it's important to put your best foot forward and be the one in the lead, because you could be in the lead for the next 50 to 100 years. And this is what's concerning about the U.S. right now. I mean, we've been in the front for a while. We have the reserve currency. That could be coming to an end because we are dragging our feet. And let me know what you think in the comment section. That's just how I see it. And the IMF meeting was just taking place. And this is a great little snippet story, which states that the Fed chairman, Jerome Powell, updates efforts to create the digital dollar, says risks and trade-offs being thoroughly evaluated. Of course, they're always thoroughly evaluating. This is the same song and dance I've been hearing for a long time, for at least a year, if not more. I'll give the benefit of the doubt. So this is what Jerome actually said. He states, "We do think it's more important to get it right than to be the first. And if we've just seen anything as far as history goes, it's important to be the first and to be right. And getting it right means that we not only look at the potential benefits of a CBDC, central bank digital currency, but also potential risks, and also recognize the important trade-offs that have to be thought through carefully. Look, I'm a business owner, and my big thing is let's just stick things against the wall, or just throw things against the wall and see what sticks. If it doesn't stick, doesn't work, we'll work around it. However, I am not in charge of the monetary policy of an entire nation. So probably that's probably for the best. So for Jerome, I will defer to him and what he says. However, it is very concerning because I haven't seen the same things forever. Anyhow, he states, "We have a responsibility both to the US and to the world that any steps taken for US digital currency be taken safely. We're absolutely committed to the soundness of the dollar and to safe and efficient US dollar payment system," and blah, blah, blah. And this is the same thing he said 6 months ago. Excuse me, 8 months ago. Right? Then this was, he states, Bitcoin surges at the Fed chair Powell declares that the U.S. is working on a digital dollar. And he was testifying before Congress in February. He states, "Hey, we're working real hard. We have a lot of projects going on, lots of efforts going on right now. We'll get to it." Same thing. And here we are, 8 months later. Where are we? We're in the same position. I mean, it really hasn't really taken off. However, I will say this. It's not like the government is really forthcoming with all their information. Maybe if they are doing things, they're just keeping under wraps. However, I don't have much faith in the current system. So I will just leave it up to the comment section and see what you guys think. I have to be rational. And he does make a good point, which is, so in addition to assessing the benefits, and there may be benefits, there are also some quite difficult policy and operational questions that need to be thoroughly evaluated. Well, yeah, I mean, there's a lot of bad policy that's being put out there. And of course, not only do the central banks want this to happen, but if I was a commercial bank, this is not in my best interest. He states, just to mention a few, I would mention the need to protect a CBDC from cyber attacks. All right. Counterfeiting and fraud. Well, if you do things in an open environment, decentralized, it's Bitcoin can't be counterfeited, and there's no fraud because it's never been hacked because there's so many nodes out there. So maybe if they do it in a way such as, they take the commercial banks and like, look, we don't really need you guys because we're going to go straight from us to the consumer, just like China's doing. Maybe they use those commercial banks as nodes. I don't know. Something like that might actually help. But again, I'm not the policymaker, thank God. The question, he states, of how a CBDC would affect monetary policy and financial stability, and how could a CBDC prevent illicit activity while also preserving user privacy and security. So I'll talk to the first part first. how could a CBDC prevent illicit activity? Well, I don't know. But right now, the US dollar is what is being used for by terrorism. It's what is being used for by the cartels and all of the other illicit activities. So you can't do much worse than what the US dollar is doing right now. But while also preserving user privacy and security, and that's interesting, because if you take away the dollar and everything is digitalized, as much as we like to say that the dollar is awful, let me tell you right now, in my sports facility, sometimes we take cash. And with cash, very hard to, I'm not saying that we do this, but I'm just saying that if we're so inclined, cash could be under the table because it's very hard to track in small amounts. Now, no one's paying us $20,000 a pop to go play in a league, but cash in that regard is pretty easy to be private and secure and all those good things. So is gold if you want to pay in gold, but no one's doing that for me. So this leads me to Raul Powell. And he's got a great new video up, and he talks about monetary policy, fiscal policy, what's going to happen. But for this context, there was a 30-second snippet, and I want you to listen to it. He's talking about the timeline of CBDCs, which is interesting from what Jerome Powell just says, and how cash is going to get phased out and the problems that come on with that. So let's take a listen.
The central bank digital currencies, I think, will come over the next 2 years. I think we're already seeing it in China. We're already seeing it in Sweden. Singapore's ready to launch, a number are, and they'll go slowly. So you'll be able to open a wallet with a central bank. You'll be able to make some transactions, and then you'll be slowly forced into the system, and then the whole system will be upon us. So I think by 3 years, there'll be mass adoption. By 5 years, there'll be no cash.
So that's a problem, because if you get rid of cash and everything is on this digitalized ledger, then the government, the central banks, and everybody else, I mean, really can take a look at what you're paying for. However, think about it this way. Do you use a debit card? Do you use a credit card? Do you think those aren't being monitored in some way, shape, or form? Well, just depends on who you ask. I personally believe that they are. So in all reality, it's just easier for the government to actually, or Big Brother, to take a look at you. Now, cash, again, you can still use it in that transaction. Gold, you can, but again, I'm not using gold coins. No one's using gold coins to me. No one's paid me in silver in, ever. So maybe those privacy coins like Monero and Zcash and others, maybe those could be the future. I haven't really checked into them, but after this little talk we're having between us, I think I really should. Anyhow, let me know what you think in the comments section. Let's move on.